You're watching Little Plan. My name's Miles, and this is the Taginn ML36. Chambered inside is an explosive faint round, and there's been a lot of concerns about the safety of these things. So just to prove that these are completely fine, I will be loading this in, giving it to my buddy, and he'll be shooting the paint deep in the chest just to prove they're perfectly fine, okay? All you have to do,
just bust this.
No, you want to pull the trigger when I tell you to do it, okay?
Alright. Nah, dog.
Come on! Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? I let your dog out. Who next to call out? Who left the call out? You catch the ball out. You take the ball out. I get to ball out. None of my dogs could say I left my dogs out. I never dog out. My fellow bloodhound. I left it all out there. Letting it all out. Go extra hard out there. Ask the dog out.
These are the explosive ones. I also have
BBs in it?
Yeah, they explode and they have BBs. I got smoke rounds, I got impact rounds in here.
You know what I mean? Let change your bad dog in the doghouse. Keep a bad bitch walk around with my bone out. She swallow puppies, you know we got
these things
on
are essentially
the
same thing as
rain catching dogs. Who is going down? Gave my dog pound, cause he hit me with a couple pounds. Tell your big dog, I break him down to puppy chow. Bah, I left your skull out. I DM DMX and say they never X the dog out.
Here we go. Let the dog out.
Here we go.
Let the dog out.
Here we go.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out.
Who let the dog out? They let the dog out. Straight out the dog out. Like they hit the fuck out. Child niggas show them out. Making a movie, show them out. Careful, what you say will get you punched in your mouth. When it's time to roll out, my niggas are going out. Coming with that hardware that your niggas don't know about. Let off the bomb out. That's how we show them out. Put a couple of bodies in the bank, then we throw them out. Serious niggas spit serious shit. When I hear your niggas spit, all I hear is a bitch. When it's time to get active, my niggas getting to it. I saying you a sucker, I'm just saying don't do it.
Let the dogs
here
out.
Here we go.
Let the dogs out.
Hey, let it go.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out.
Talk to me.
Let the dogs out. Let the dogs out.
Let it go.
Let the dogs out.
It's TDM. I've got some flat things. These are Taginn FPV6s, and they make a big bright flash. So.
I had to. I had to.
I fucking love it.
Let's like, subscribe, and go to plan.
There you go.
What's good, y'all? It's your boy Miles, and this time around, I'm going to be doing something a little bit different by making my first ever review. Just for transparency, this is all my own genuine opinion. I'm not sponsored, paid, or anything like that. So if I missed anything you're trying to get info on, go ahead and leave your questions in the comments below. I'll probably just respond to them there, but if I end up getting a bunch, I'll just answer them all in a follow-up video. The Taginn ML36 is undeniably the Lamborghini of grenade launchers, with its audacious $730 price tag, futuristic aesthetic, and a loud, deafening presence on the field, announcing to everyone that you've seriously got something special. This thing will obliterate your wallet long before it does the enemy, because this isn't any run-of-the-mill grenade launcher. Typically, when it comes to airsoft ones, they take these 40mm shotgun type shells that shoot a large spread of BBs at once, which sort of works with CQB, but in my experience, you could just get the job done with a hand grenade or getting on that fast-paced John Wick mess with the pistol. There are also what are called 40 mics, which shoot out a ton of BBs too, but instead of a giant shower, it's all in this super painful concentrated beam that's more effective at taking out groups. The problem with that though is that it's still not shooting grenades in the way that you'd expect a grenade launcher to work. And on top of that, it's only really good for CQB, which is where the ML36 comes in. This jewel to the crown of any rifle fires actual 35mm ammo, is powered by CO2, and is easily the most well-built grenade launcher on the market. Its tight tolerances and aircraft-grade CNC aluminum reassures you that this isn't some cheaply built toy, but a solid unit built like a tank, ready to take on any abuse you throw at it. Despite its durable structure that's strong enough to hold up to the recoil of a real rifle, it still doesn't weigh a ton thanks to its polymer barrel that's rifled on the inside, allowing you to fire shots out to 150 meters accurately. Its design is based off the real-world MWT-40, whose ergonomics are the perfect love child of the American M203 and German M320. The controls are straightforward and easy to manipulate in the middle of a game. All you have to worry about are two buttons. One is for the safety, and the other is for reloading. Pressing the button for reloading causes the tube to instantly pop out on the side like an M320, so you can insert or remove a round. Although a side popping tube isn't as satisfying as an M203's design of pushing the tube forward, popping a round in, and then slamming it back, having the tube pop out on the side definitely allows you to reload faster. To put a round into the launcher, you first want to start off by preparing the ammo before a match by taking whatever type of ammo you're using, putting it into this little black shell, and putting that nice little package into the tube. Since the tube is rifled, you will have to align the grooves of the round into the tube, which can be quickly done by just twisting the round until it falls into place. In the box, the launcher will come with 5 of these shells alongside some extra O-rings and a manual. If you manage to lose them, you can just buy a pack of 12 for $15. A big thing that I really like about the ML36's layout is that unlike an M320, there's no pistol grip, no foregrip, and a heavy bulky design that overall adds a ton of weight onto the front of your rifle. But you still get to have its side reloading mechanism while also having the M203's more streamlined design of just being a tube with a trigger in front of the mag well. The leaf sight that holds the CO2 cartridge isn't just for show either. You can zero the front sight for windage, and the rear sight has markings for multiple ranges. To insert the CO2, you simply hold down this button to twist the front sight off. You put in a CO2 cartridge, and then you cock the leaf sight back to puncture the CO2 once you've put the front sight back on. This silver button is for emptying out CO2 when you want to refill the launcher, as if you try taking off the front sight without emptying the CO2, the front sight won't budge at all. You don't want to leave CO2 inside the launcher for long amounts of time, as that can damage the launcher's O-rings, which can result in your launcher leaking out air in the long run. In my experience, the launcher is good for about 5 shots before it needs a new cartridge, which is way better than their CO2 shells, which needs to be refilled after 1 shot. You can actually shoot about 6 to 7 shots out of the ML36, but the last 2 won't go very far for obvious reasons, so I wouldn't bother trying to stretch extra shots out of it unless it's like a smoke round at close range. Take into account that the sight isn't removable due to it being the part that holds the CO2, so this launcher won't fit every rifle. It can fit most quad rails including the SCAR-H, but if it doesn't fit your primary, you'll have to find workarounds like buying their standalone kit to use it without putting it on a rifle, or buying their CO2 shells for normal launchers. I could go and compare the performance of the CO2 shells against the ML36, since I do have experience with both, but I'll probably save that for a follow-up video if enough of you are interested in that. Now that you know what this does and how to operate it, let's get on to the different ammo types. You've got smoke rounds, timed explosive, impact rounds, chalk rounds, and finally training rounds, all of which serve different purposes but are all equally satisfying to fire because of its surprising amount of recoil that hits a little bit harder than a gas blowback rifle. The visual feedback is just as great too, with the CO2 smoke coming out of the tube giving you that sort of video game cool guy feel. When it comes to the 2 types of explosive rounds they make, they're everything you want them to be in order to fulfill your Modern Warfare 2 fantasies of getting easy low skill double kills. The yellow Reaper rounds will explode after 3.5 or 4.5 seconds depending on which ammo you buy. The gray Fate rounds will explode instantly upon impact, and if they don't do that for some reason, like say, shooting them into the dirt, they will detonate after 4.5 seconds. Personally, I find the Reaper rounds to be worse, because the 3.5 second timer gives most people plenty of time to run away, while the Fate rounds instantly blow up. They both cost the same amount, so in the future, I'll likely just stick with the Fate ammo. For both rounds, the explosion is fucking amazing, and you can hear them from pretty far away too.
Oh wow!
I'd say they're about 135 decibels loud, which will inevitably put a smile on not only your face, but the people around you too. Once the ringing in their ears stops, of course. Trust me when I say this, you will absolutely be turning heads with this thing.
Right there, see the shield? Damn, fuck. Do it.
Oh, no way.
There we go.
Dude! Oh, no. Dude, we got one of that. Nice.
Hell yeah.
Holy shit.
Hell yeah, bro.
Hell yeah.
You already know, bro. Those enemies are on the opposite side of the fence.
Yeah.
Let's try something. We make them disappear like damn dog chickens. Oh, God damn it, I hit the tree again. Yeah.
Although they're explosive, they're still pretty safe for the most part. You shouldn't be trying to get the rounds to directly hit someone, but if you do, they'll hurt for a while like a shot from a BB does. These aren't like actual full-on military-type explosive rounds designed to destroy buildings or kill people. They're more for shooting into a room or near someone, and having them being count as dead based on how far you are from the explosion or if the BBs inside the round hit you. And since I wouldn't shoot something at people that I wouldn't be okay with being shot at me.
You want to know the plan? My name's Miles, and this is the Taginn ML36. Chambered inside is an explosive faint round. And there's been a lot of concerns about the safety of these things. So just to prove that these are completely fine, I will be loading this in, giving it to my buddy, and he'll be shooting the paint deep in the chest just to prove they're perfectly fine, okay? All you have to do, right?
Just bust this.
No, you gotta pull the trigger when I tell you to do it, okay?
Alright. Alright, tell me when I'm good.
Good.
That was a test. I only lost my hand, but perfectly fine.
You okay?
Yeah.
A certain someone shot me in my face, but I had my hands over it, so I was perfectly fine. I'd say the pain was slightly worse than a paintball before my hand went numb, but I didn't bleed or get permanent damage. Matter of fact, I was good enough to go on and do a little raid with my gas mask and some smoke grenades at Ghost Town, which will probably be the next video I put up. Don't take this as a green light to start trying to directly hit people with these at point blank, but just know that if you do manage to accidentally hit someone straight on, they're not going to be too hurt. Next up are the blue colored Paladin rounds. These ones cost a lot cheaper and they don't explode, but they still have their use. When fired, the misleadingly blue colored polymer will instantly shatter upon impact, causing tons of red chalk dust to pop out, leaving a big red mark on the wall that people will definitely notice. I haven't directly shot anyone with it, but according to Taginn's marketing, it's non-toxic and can be easily washed off. Typically, the Milsom crowd will use these to mark a point of interest or something like that for their team, but I prefer to use them as a cheaper alternative to the explosive rounds, which will run you about $100 for a box of 10, not including the $30 to $40 in hazmat shipping due to being pyrotechnics. These things are $50 for a box of 10 and aren't pyrotechnics, which ironically will allow you to get more bang for your buck. Once again, I don't shoot these directly at people, but if you shoot them at a wall or into a room near an enemy, you can still get those multi-kills based on the 10 meter rule because it has that dust effect going on. When it comes to the smoke ammo named Velum rounds, I wasn't a big fan of these. Despite the idea of smoke rounds sounding quite cool, I personally found them better for bragging than actually providing cover. Maybe I got a bad batch, but in my experience, they have a tendency to be duds and more trouble than they're worth. Out of the box of 10, only half of them worked, with the rest doing nothing, even after trying to shoot them multiple times. The white smoke looks cool, but it puts out less smoke than an $8 Enola Gay grenade. It doesn't sit in the air very long compared to an Enola Gay, and it's not cold burning like an Enola Gay, which I personally find to be pretty bad. If you screw up a shot, which you probably will end up doing if you're new to the thing, you can't just pick it back up and try to throw it yourself, as it will immediately burn right through your gloves since it gets hot like a stove iron in seconds. Meanwhile, with an Enola Gay, I can easily pick them back up with no problem at all. Since these cost more, aren't as reliable, and don't perform well even when they do work, I won't be buying these again since they cost $100 for a box of 10 like the explosives. The weirdly named Pecker rounds can be reused for a long while since they're polymer dummy rounds that are for getting a feel on how to aim the grenade launcher before you shoot whatever explosive ammo you choose to use during an actual game. These things are really cheap. You can get two of them for $11 and then just reuse them over and over again. They take a bit of damage with every shot, so they will last you for a while, but they aren't impervious to damage. Overall, I think the ML36 is a very fun, useful piece of equipment, but it's a major money hog even once you're able to afford it. The sheer price of everything makes it so you really can only use it for special occasions rather than just any day when you're going out airsofting. Seriously, this video was $600 worth of ammo on top of the $750 grenade launcher, so it's going to be a long while before I use this thing again. If you liked this video, I would really appreciate it if you helped me out by liking, leaving a comment, sharing, and of course subscribing. I make these videos and pay for everything all by myself, so it really means a lot to me when you guys like the stuff I put months of work and tons of money into creating. Be sure to check out my Instagram too. I announce when I'll be going to a field ahead of time, so if you got a camera, I got no problem giving you a shout out if you send me the footage you got of me. Speaking of shout outs, another thank you to Viper Airsoft for sending me some more footage. He goes to the same field I do, so if you like gameplay of the field, go ahead and check his channel out. I'd like to make another shout out to Enski Lives on Instagram. She takes the real high quality photos you see of me and Wyatt on Instagram. She captured some of the footage for this video and a night vision video that I'm probably going to put up once I get this gas mask gameplay done. I realized it's probably more engaging for the people just to speak for themselves, so here you go.
Hi, I'm Nadia. I'm also another filmmaker, and follow my Instagram, Enski Lives underscore film. He does credit me in some of the work, so please check out his channel. And I'll see you guys later.
Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, I have like no idea how to like cleanly sign off videos. So for now on, it's just gonna be a thing to abruptly end.